I think I always wanted to be a scientist that does conservation especially, but I think now I have this incredible platform that I really don't want to let go of. And I hope, of course, I will be the one that's providing the data, but I'm also hoping that I will be the one that will be communicating my science to the public. In between my master's and starting at A&M, I actually lived in Costa Rica for quite a while, about 8 years, where I did conservation work on marine turtles. So the marine biology interdisciplinary graduate program is fairly new, so it's only a few years old. And of course, the majority of people that apply to the program would rather stay at the coast in Galveston or Corpus Christi. And so there's not that many people here on campus that do study marine biology. 4.4 kilograms. When I was conducting my first season of research for my PhD work, we were capturing turtles and brought them onto a boat. And when we had this one particular male on the boat, we were also sampling little critters that live on turtles, parasites and others. And we found something encrusted in the nose of that particular male.
Okay, I'm filming. You can go for it.
So I cut off a piece and my local system bit on it. It was plastic. So yes, that was how we found out it was a plastic straw that was lodged into the turtle's nose.
I'm sorry, little one. I think you like it better afterwards, though.
When I had the video in my hand, I really wanted to publish it and show the world what I had seen, because for me this is a reality, but not so much for all the other people out there. So I knew that I'm conducting research with Texas A&M University, and I needed to run it by my advisor to just know what she thinks and if she would back me up for whatever happens after. But she also believed that we really need to show the world the realities of plastic and what kind of harm it can do to wildlife. And so we published it as is. And then this video happened, and that video provided me and still provides me with a platform that is beyond of what I would have ever imagined. Of course, I also get more opportunities to talk to the next generation. So I've been on a bunch of panels with the next generation STEM, especially with girls. So I always like to talk to them and give them ideas of what they can do to become a biologist or scientist.